Hey everyone, this is Timothy from Master of Memory, and I'm going to show you how using a memory palace is going to improve your speed and success in scripture memory by more than double. Let's say we had to memorize Romans 2:1, and I just kind of pulled this up because it was the first verse that I thought of. Therefore, you have no excuse, O man, every one of you who judges. For in passing judgment on another, you condemn yourself, because you, the judge, practice the very same things. The tactic that we'll use is more than 2,500 years old, and yet it's surprising how few people use it. I'm going to ask you right now to imagine that you wake up in your bed in the morning, and then you take a trip to your kitchen table for breakfast. Now, there will be 5 locations along this path that we're going to use. First, your bed, where you wake up. Second, you'll make a stop in the closet to pick up your clothes. Third, you go to your bathroom for a bath. Fourth, you'll go to the refrigerator to pick up the food, and then finally you'll sit down at the kitchen table. It's a fairly logical progression, right? It seems like a natural thing to do in the morning. Now let's break the verse up and place different parts of the verse along that path, all right? And the point is to take what the verse is saying and somehow turn it into some sort of funny image in that location to make it memorable. For example, every time it says judges, we'll think of a classic judge with a wig and a black robe. So in the first place, imagine that you wake up in your bed to a noisy alarm, and you think, therefore you have no excuse, O man. I guess because it's such a loud alarm. In the second place, the closet, it's full of wigs and black robes. Every one of you who judges. In the third place, the bathtub, you're washing your rubber ducky with a bar of soap that says, judgment, passing judgment on another. In the fourth place, your refrigerator, you step inside and lock yourself in. You condemn yourself. And then finally, in the fifth place, at the kitchen table, you put on your judge's wig, you pick up a basketball, and you start dribbling on the table because you, the judge, practice the very same things. Alright? Now, to remember this verse, all you have to do is remember each of those locations along the path. What's the beginning of the verse? The first place, when you woke up to the alarm. Therefore, you have no excuse, O man. Second place is the closet, every one of you who judges. The third place is the bathtub, where you're washing your rubber ducky, for in passing judgment on another. The fourth place is the refrigerator, you condemn yourself. And then finally, remember the kitchen table, because you, the judge, practice the very same things. This is called the Loci method, or the memory palace method. Basically, we're just imagining a path that's memorable with several locations along the path, and we just place different parts of something that we want to remember, or different elements, on different parts of that path. Then, to remember all of those elements, all we have to do is retrace our steps and think along that path. Monks and religious leaders for millennia have been using this method to memorize whole books of the Bible and other important passages of literature. What we just did is a simplistic example, and it may take a couple of times of maybe rewatching this video to learn that verse that we just did, but you can see how effective it is. When we memorize the book of James in March, we're actually going to put different verses at different locations. So when you think of different locations by number, you'll actually be calling up different verses. That's why I call it a memory palace of indexed verses, because you'll be able to remember each verse by the number of that index. You'll be able to go to any location in the memory palace and pull out that verse. Now here's the best part. When we memorize James, I'll have a memory palace already built for you, one where you'll be able to store any scripture memorization you want to do at all. You could put the whole Bible in there if you want. Plus, I'll show you exactly how to make those verses memorable. All the work will be done ahead of time for you. You won't have to think up your own mnemonics. You just have to follow the program, and it'll all stick immediately. Thanks so much, and I'll talk to you all again soon.